Returning to our original example of me ordering a ticket to go to India via Expedia and Delta, let's now identify all the events that are connected directly by the happen before relationship. So if these are the events in my process, then we know that A happened before H, and we know that H happened before I, and we know that I happened before L. So that's the textual ordering, and we know that process is sequential. This is the ordering of events in my process. And similarly, we can see that if these are the events in Expedia's process, then all these events have to be sequentially ordered. So B should have happened before C, C should have happened before F, F should have happened before G, and G should have happened before M. So these are the orderings of the events in Expedia's process. And similarly, we can derive the order of events in the Delta process as sequential. And these are all the communication events that are directly relating events happening between any two processes that I'm showing you in this picture. So for instance, E to F is a message from Delta back to Expedia confirming my reservation. So E is the act of sending the message from Delta, and F is the act of receiving the same message from Delta on Expedia. So those are all the communication events. And now we can also look at transitive events. So for instance, what is the relationship between, let's say, event E and event A? Well, it turns out that A must have happened before event E. And the reason is, if you look at A, it happened before B, B happened before C, C happened before D. All of these are communication events, pretty straightforward. So from here to here, it's not a communication event. But since the process is sequential, B should have happened before C. And of course, C happened before D. So since it's a communication event, sequential process, D should have happened before E. And that's what gives the transitive relationship between A and E, that A must have happened before E. Similarly, we can identify other events that are transitively connected to one another because of the happen before relationship. So for instance, D and M apparently don't have any direct connection, but through the transitivity of events that are happening sequentially and through the communication and sequentiality of the process, we know that D must have happened before M. So those are transitive events. And finally, let's look at concurrent events. If you think about this event M that's happening in Expedia, basically Expedia has confirmed to me that I have the booking that I want. Then it is doing some internal bookkeeping to record some information about me, maybe my preferences in terms of airlines and so on and so forth. And from that point of view, it is making some internal bookkeeping, and that's this event M. And now if you look at this event M, it has no relationship to any of the events that are happening here. I'm showing G, this event H must have happened after G. But what about H and M? There is no relationship between these two guys. This could have happened much later than this in wall clock time, or it could have happened much sooner than event M. So you can see that H is concurrent with M, and in fact, all the events that you see here are going to be concurrent with M. And similarly, all the events that you're seeing over here, they're concurrent with M. So in fact, after this, if you look at the Delta process, after Delta has sent this message to Expedia confirming my booking, it may have done a whole bunch of events over here. All of those events are concurrent with M because there is no ordering between these events and the events over here. But there is an ordering between the event G and the event J here, because G happened before H, H happened before I happened before J. So you can see that transitivity connects events across machines, but there could be events that are happening in the distributed system that are unconnected to other events, and those are concurrent events. That completes discussion of the basics of distributed system. Next, we're going to start talking about Lamport's clock.